it's Sara. Let's see. Oh, good. My battery's all charged up. I want to come on here and tell you guys about these last two. I posted these on my Facebook page, these little stained glass pieces. So look at these. They're so cute. I'm going to take you through my process for making these. And those of you who watch my videos, you know that I switch around a lot from craft to craft. So if stained glass is not your thing, maybe it should be. No. You can definitely check back, because I have a lot of other different videos. I really, really, really want to get the polymer clay out. I'm going to be doing some more Altoid tins. And these are just some boho bracelets that I made. But these are so fun, and I'm going to do the applique technique. So that'll be coming. But for now, I'm doing stained glass, and I was so happy with how these turned out. These actually both of these designs were inspired by Pinterest. Things that I saw on Pinterest, and I sketched them out. I think I did this with you guys one day. I'm not sure. But I just take graph paper, which I love. I got this big graph paper. I think I got it at Staples. And I just sketch out design ideas for stained glass, because as I've evolved in my crafting, because I started out as a decorative painter, and in decorative painting you use other people's designs. But now, because of mixed media and all the copyright laws and the different, you know, people get really angry about if you copy their design, you know, and it's a tricky situation. So what I've been trying to do is really, even if I am inspired by something, I mean, a heart's a heart. You can't really copyright a heart, you know, but certain things, an angel's an angel. These have been around forever, I'm sure. This is just your basic shape of an angel. I have them all around my craft room. So it's not like this can be copyrighted, but I have been trying to put my own twist on things. And when I started doing stained glass, I kind of just did traditional stained glass panels and things, but now I'm playing around with my own ideas, and I have seen people using this copper wire and things like that. So I'm adding that in. I'm adding the beads to it as well, because I've done beading. So it's fun for me now to kind of start to combine my loves, all my different the crafts that I enjoy doing. So that's what this is. It's kind of a combo of things. Anywho, so here's my angel. Basically, look, it's three pieces of glass. Kiwi, stop biting. Kiwi's on my shoulder. She's getting my bra strap. It's three pieces of glass, two clear ones for the wings and pink for the body. And then these, I just went outside and grabbed a couple more. These were in, I have these glass domes on my front porch. They're just colored, just to give color. And they're, you put them in the bottom of a vase, and I have a candle in there. But I just pulled out some bigger ones, and these are actually maybe a little too big. But that way, I can make a little character using that as the head. So I tried to find ones that were clear. This one has a bubble in it. You know, they're not perfect, but I think I'm going to use a couple of these to show you guys how I do this. So you start with that. Now, for the girl, she also has boobies. She's got boobies that are, see, look, I have all these too. Look how gorge. I've taken these aside to use in different stained glass mosaics and things like that. I've also gotten these, which are, I got these at Hobby Lobby, and they're for fusing, which I've never done. I don't have a kiln, but they're good circles, so I got some of them. Anywho, I have mirror in here. Just a piece of mirror. Kiwi, stop. You're getting on my nerves. Sorry. I had to yell at my bird. But let's see if these are both. They're a little off. I have a few in here that are all ready to go. But I'll find two that match, and I'll go downstairs. Now, most of my glass supplies are in the basement because glass is, it's glass. It's going to splinter and get little shards of glass all over the place. Let me come back up so you can see what I'm doing. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to find, so let me set these aside. So let's see, I'll use this for her head. There's a little, I'll use that one. Anywho, I'm going to find two little, let's see, purple would be so cute. So I made her orange. I'm going to make one, the next one blue or purple or red, and I'm going to just make a dress that will match the color of the boobies that I pick. And then for my angel, I have other, I'm going to make a different color. So I may make her blue. Maybe we'll go with a blue theme this time. And I have different kinds of wing. So this is just an iridized, it has a little bumpy waviness to it. But I'm going to find a different white for the wings and I'm going to do a different shape. So let me show you how we're going to tweak the shape this time. I'm going to take a piece of graph paper. Let me clear, get this out of my way for a minute. Because I don't, it takes a lot and I talk a lot, so I don't need to take you through every step. I have other, I've done a few stained glass videos now that you can go back and look through and you'll definitely get some things that I might have left out if I'm leaving anything out. But I'll go through the steps. So basically this is where I start. So let's just say these are, I'm going to do purple. That they look good. Proportionate boobies, right? So I'm going to, because I'm going to use this one piece of paper for both designs. So I like to center it on the, I'm going to go down a little so you can see what I'm doing. Okay, good. So I'm going to center it. Like, so by center, I just mean this is her neck, say. And then I'm just going to trace around this head, just so I know where I'm going. The boobies would be next. And again, they're not, okay, I like that. This is, they're both kind of going that way. And you want to connect them. Oops. It doesn't have to be perfect. I'm going to put them aside so I know where they are. And they want to be connected to each other, so touching each other. It's a little wonky. But now I want to make a dress. And because this one had a little bit of a shorter dress, right? I'm going to make this one have maybe, say, a little bell-shaped dress. So she's going to have a dress that goes like this. And I think I'm going to curve it like this at the bottom. Does that look cute? I don't know. I think it will. And then she's going to have hair too. That was something that I added. The ones on that I saw on Pinterest didn't have hair. I don't think it's rocket science that things have hair. So I'm sure there are some that have hair, but these didn't. Now I could give her wire hair. And I've been using copper wire. This is bare copper. This is, one of them is silver. It says tinned copper. So this has already been tinned. So that means it's silver. 20 and 18 gauge. This is 18 gauge. It's a bit thicker, which I like too. And that's what I made her legs out of and her arms. So let's see what kind of hair. I think like pigtails would be super cute. You could do that. You could do a bun. I don't know how a bun would be. Maybe I'm just going to go with a similar. I like to put the part on the side. I don't know why. And maybe it's just going to go down straight this time instead of having. And let me think. I think that'll be cool. She's got a big head. And I mean, the arms are going to come from here. No, they're not. They're going to come from here and go down. Boy, she is busty. This one is a busty one. So that's how she, my other girl, is going to look. She's much bigger. She has a bigger head. And then for my angel, this one's going to be bigger too because it's starting with this globe. So I'm going to do this. Same way, center it. So like this would be the center. And then... And you know, if you don't have glass, you could do this out of paper. You could do it out of chipboard and just make the whole thing a paper background and then glue these on top to give it that dimension, you know? And I mean, you can use wire. You could just make beads. Just sprinkle seed beads or what are they called? Micro beads all over things. I don't know. I think this just is, I'm in a creative mood today. So I'm kind of, all right. Now for my angel, I think I'm going to keep the body very similar to how I had it. Let's see how big this one is. I'll make it a little taller because it's bigger. I'm going to go down to about here. So I just curve it, just follow. For some reason, my pencil just finds the curve like that. I don't know. And then, so it's over to here. All right, and I'll just do it flat at the bottom. You can use a ruler. I just haven't been using a ruler because when I cut it out, I'll use this line and make it a straight line. Now the wings, I want to make them a bit different this time, right? I think I want to make them, I'm going to only go, I don't want to go too far. I'm going to make them like right here. So this is the center. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That's why I like using graph paper. So this is just going to go straight to here. See, I will use my ruler. I do like to make a straight line. And this is getting on my nerves. I have washi tape back here from when I went to my class, but it keeps sticking to the edge of paper. Anywho. I kind of want to make it, see, they're very tall. I want to make this one flared out, like, I want to make it come to here. But I really want to make these big. So this is how you just play with the design, and once you decide what you want to do, so I like that. Look how these are like way more narrow, and these are going to be spread out more. And you can actually make curves and stuff, but I'm really trying to keep it simple so that I can just get the effect that I want with the least amount of work and the least amount of stress. Because when you have to cut things in a curve, it makes it a little more stressful. Not stressful. It's not stressful at all. All right, now how far did this come out? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So I want that to come to here, so it's going to come around. And it's not perfect. That's the best part, is it's, I did it. So I am just, I love it. I love it. I love the big openness. Now I have to find a cool piece of glass to make that with. And then it's going to have, I'm definitely loving that I'm using these letter beads. And these are just the little kids' letter beads I've had in my stash forever. And I hope I have enough of these gold beads, which I'm sure I just got at Michael's Racing. I get a lot of my beading stuff. I used to order online, but now I get a lot of it at Michaels and AC Moore. So we'll see if I have enough to make another halo, because I really love the way that halo looks with the gold and white. You could use silver beads. Like, maybe I'll patina this one differently too. I won't use the gold, it's copper patina. We'll see. And I'll use silver wire and I'll use silver. Ooh, but see, then I gotta find silver beads. I definitely have silver beads, so I think I might do that. So if I'm making a set, or I just want to make them all different, you know? And then I love the rickrack idea at the neck and at the bottom of the dress. And then I love that, you know, and this one I think I'll make, say, hope, maybe. But it could say inspire, anything. And then I could make swirlies on the wing this time, which that would be really cool. But, and then maybe not give her hair, because I don't need hair, and then just make a halo. I think I might do that, because I definitely want to change it up. So I'm going to do that. I'm going to make swirlies out of silver wire. So my glass doesn't have to be super fancy or anything. I'm liking that. Now, what about my girl here? Does she, cause see, I kind of like, I mean, she just has straight hair. I like it. Her boobies are a little, everything's bigger because her head was bigger. And like, I could put them this way, which I kind of like better, going in that direction. I think I like that, but maybe we'll do them wider this time. So there's a lot of options, guys, a lot of playing around, and it's just what you think. And she doesn't need big feet, like a lot down here, because her dress is a little longer. So I may tweak it and I'll see. But now I'm gonna go choose. First, I have to make two copies of this. So I'm gonna go to my printer and print out two copies, and then I'll show you the next step. So the next thing, I've made my copies. Well, these are two copies here. I already started cutting, but I figured, yeah, I'll show you what I'm doing. So I just cut out just to get them easier to handle, because this outside edge you can cut with regular scissors, just your regular house scissors. But the other parts, anything that's connected, usually, and it's probably not even that big a deal in this case, you use these, they're called foiling scissors or foil scissors. Let's see if it says it on here. I don't know. But there's three blades, and I've shown you this in previous videos, because it makes a gap that when you put your glass together, it leaves a little extra room for the tape so that the puzzle will fit together better. And these aren't the best examples of that. It's better to see a panel or something. So for now, I am going to use them. I'm not going to use them on the edges. Like, it's just, they're easier to cut out with these. So I'm just going to go around the main pattern lines. With the straight scissors. Hi, Kiwi. I don't know why. I could just cut the whole thing out with the other ones, but they're a little more tricky. I'll show you why. Because paper gets stuck in between the third blade. So I'll show you. So right here, I'll show you. They don't open as easy, so it's just quicker. I'm very impatient. So anything that gets me there faster. Oops. So, but that's good. I got that wing. Now, you need to save this, because this is what you're using for your pattern. So I'm gonna cut. See, I could have gone down here. So just know that if you were cutting out a pattern, you need to use these fancy scissors. Do as I say, not as I do. That's a good rule of thumb with me, because I'm a corner cutter, and I like to fudge things if I can. So follow the rules and do the right thing. All right, so this is your pattern, basically. We only needed three pieces, 1, 2, 3, because we have our head. And then I'm going to go pick glass, and we're going to glue that on. And you've seen me do this in the past. So I'm going to cut her out, and I'll come back, and I'll show you how I glue these pieces to the glass, and then I'll cut them out. Now, I do have a tutorial about glass cutting. I'm not going to show you that today because I just don't feel like bringing my camera all the way down the basement and setting it all up down there. But maybe I'll put the link to where I show you that in the description box. I'm not going to show you how I grind the glass or get it anything, but I'll show you how I foil it and then how I solder. So I'll be back in a minute. All right, so this little section will be called choosing glass for a project. And these aren't the best projects to share this, because there's a lot of different kinds of glass out there, and it does make a difference. I am really basing it on using what I have, and in this case, an angel, which is very, spiritual, in the sky, floating around, or whatever angels do. I had this piece of glass, and it was something I'd never used. It's got an iridescence to it, but it's not transparent. So this is not cathedral glass. This is opaque. And so, but I think I want to do her. This one has transparent wings and opaque body, but it's iridescent, and I love it, and it has a transparent head. I actually, because I'm going to do the wire work on her wings, I thought using this type of glass would be cool for her wings. So this is what my angel's colors are going to be. So I like that. And I use scraps if I have them. So I go through a lot of my scraps and see what I can find. Now for the girl, because I chose purple, all I need is this. This is purple. And then I have hair. So I have a couple different versions of purple. This is definitely a cathedral glass. It's sheer. And I think that's a pretty good match. I'm going to hold it up. It's not easy. It would go, all right? Just take my word for it. But I think I'm going to do it with, and then this is a different purple. This is a striated purple. It's not sheer. And it would do it. It would go, especially if I put it with more of the lighter color purples. But that wasn't my choice either. I think I'm going to go with this one. And again, it's just personal preference and what you have, but maybe it won't look right because her boobies are see-through. So that's actually something to think about. But a dress could be like sheer on top, and you know what? I'm not going to use this. I'll go with the first purple. Just oopsie. In looking at it, I think it's probably better. This isn't the exact color. Like, this is a bit lighter. But I like that it's see-through. I think I'm going to go with this one. And, you know, who knows? You know, you just, I think it's going to look fantastic. And then this is, I'm going to make her a blonde-ish. I have a lot of different, I could have gone red. But like, this is just a tad lighter than this brown, so I'm going to make her this color. And on this side, it's even lighter. So I'm going to use this for her hair. And all you have to do is decide, well, first of all, is your glass bumpy? Now, this is the front. It's got a waviness to it, all right? And you don't want to cut your glass on that side. You want to cut it on the smooth side. So when you're positioning your pattern, keep that in mind. This is the front of my pattern. This is how I want it to look when I cut it, but I have to glue it to the back because that's the flat side. So I'm going to glue it just using a glue stick, and I'm going to glue the front of the paper to the back of the glass. And for the rest of them, I'm probably going to just, you'll see. And then I just like to use the edges of the glass to get it to waste. Oopsie, my doggy. What's the matter, Grunchy? Grunchy. So when I cut this, I can just go straight across, and I'm only using the corner of this glass. And then for the hair, let me just get a baby wipe. Wipe this off a little bit. I just want to see if this side, I kind of like this side. It's a little bit lighter. And I like this side. So this is going to be the front. It's flat, so I don't have to worry about sticking it to the wrong side. And then when you do the hair, so I'm just going to put this right on here. Let's see. There's a couple little striations. I'm just going to put it like that. So this time I'm putting the glue on the back of the paper. And I'm going to cut this. When I cut this, I use the paper as my template, as my guide to cut the glass. And I'm going to grind it so all the edges are smooth. And then we'll be ready to go. Actually, I don't want to do that. I want to keep it. Hold on. You have to consider when you cut. All right, I'll just do it like this. Because I want to make sure I can cut straight. And so you don't want to break your glass. Because you can, if these sometimes curves can break. So that looks good. So that's ready to go. And then I do the same thing for my angel. I'm probably going to be able to get both the wings out of this piece. I'm really hopeful. Yeah. Look at that. Perfect. And well, maybe not perfect, but yeah, I can definitely fit both pieces of the wings, which I love this. Yeah, I don't know. Maybe I'll go this way. Oh boy. You have to do it however it's going to fit, you know? So, and like I said, I'm covering these wings with wire. So they're going to have decoration on them. And then her body is going to be this color. And this is pretty all the same. Oh, there's a bump right there. So I probably won't want to put my, I'm just going to put it on the edge, like right there. I'll glue that there. And next time I come back, everything will be cut and ready to go. And I'm going to put the copper tape on the edges of the glass. So I'll be back. Oh, I also have to bring my gems down with me to grind the edges of these, because in order to add the copper foil tape, you want a smooth edge. So I'm going to grind these down. And actually, that might be important when you're considering your design, but it hasn't been an issue for me so far. So I'm going to bring these down too. So next time you see me, everything will be, I'll probably have foiled most of the glass, and I'll just go over real quick how I foil everything. But then it's going to be on to solder and putting it all together. All right, so I'll be back. Okay, I'm back, and it's the next day, so I don't even remember what I was doing. Yes, I do. So everything's ready to go. I've put the copper foil on all the pieces of glass except for one. Just to remind you that this is the copper foil, and this is actually copper backed. So that means it has copper on the back and the front. You can buy it black, silver. So basically whatever patina you're going to use, like I did on these guys, this is the copper patina, so that I turned the silver pink. You can turn the silver black. So here, this is my little, so see, I used the black. And if you could see through the glass, it only really matters if you can see through the glass. So like on the gems, you'll be able to see that it's copper inside. So I was going to keep these silver. We'll see how it goes, but for now, this is all I have anyway, so I don't really have a choice. And I'm impatient, and I will just, you know, I am going to use what I have. Anywho, so you want to center that, the glass. Now, generally the glass is pretty, most of the glass pieces I've noticed are the same width, or I guess you could call it like ply or whatever, but like these gems are much thicker than glass, and some of the pieces of glass are a little bit thicker. You see what I'm saying? Like this side thicker. I use the 7/32, so 7/32 of an inch wide. I don't know why that is the most commonly used width, but it seems to be. Although I did buy the 1/4 inch, which is a little bit wider than this, on Amazon, and so I have some of that, and that's what I used to do the gems with. But for any normal, you know what I bought it for too originally was to do china when I was going to make the jewelry, when I was making little pieces of jewelry, because little pieces of china were much thicker than this type of glass, than the studio glass, I guess you'd call it. All right, and then you want to fold it down on the edges, like kind of bevel your corners if you can, or miter, I guess. So I go up to the edge and then I pinch, and then you just slide it around and pinch. So basically you want to cover half on this side and half on that side, so you get even coverage. Because the copper tape is what the solder sticks to, that when you use the flux, that's how you're going to hold everything together. So you need to kind of burnish this down. And I have this fancy little tool. I don't even know. I think I got this at the shop that I took my classes at. But it's just a little roller, and you just roll that tape. Give it, make sure it has good adhesion. Make sure it's stuck. And that's basically it. So then you place it and you're ready to solder. So I'm going to turn on my iron, and I think I'm going to do a part two. So I think I'm going to go away and start part two with the soldering and all the wire work that we're going to do. So this was preparing and cutting your glass, and well, you didn't see me do that. Anywho, all right? So I'm going to go away and come back with part two, which will be finishing these guys up. All right, thanks for watching.